Welcome to Practice Update. I'm your host, Dr. Aman Shah. I'm here with Dr. Thaji Trong. Welcome, Dr. Trong.
Thank you for having me.
I wanted to talk to you about your approach or the algorithm that you might use for a patient who has stage 4 melanoma. How do you approach the treatment plan and what evidence-based or rational input can you put into this?
Yes, I think we've had several studies that would help guide this decision at this point, both prospective and retrospective. Today, they presented the CheckMate 067 study that looked at nivolumab plus ipilimumab, nivolumab versus nivolumab alone versus ipilimumab alone. We've been following that study now through these 5 years, and we've finally had an update. And that's looking at wild-type or BRAF mutant-positive tumors, patients who have these, and what they might receive if they chose to do immunotherapy first. And what's very interesting at this point is that it does look to be a survival benefit if you do both agents together, although nivolumab in single agent is shortly on its heels. So close to 60% versus 40%. And what we don't have an answer for yet is if you did them in sequence, whether you might get to the same outcome. So in practice, if you're sitting across from a patient, I think it is important to discuss that yes, there's a bigger response rate, there might be a survival benefit. However, the toxicity rates also have to be considered. And so the toxicity rates are twice that of the single agent if you do ipilimumab, nivolumab together right up front. Right. So you might have a different discussion with someone who's young and fit versus someone who's older. There has been also data that patients who are older might respond better. And so I think there's still significant data that we'd want to know to decide whether we might want to give a single agent or dual agent in the first
line. And how would their BRAF status impact your decision making for the frontline therapy?
That's exactly right. So for someone with a BRAF mutation, today's presentation confirms that they do better with the combination. And so if they're fit, I think it's very important, to discuss that with them. And they do seem to be those that would benefit the most, or those who are perhaps sicker to begin with, both for the overall response rate as well as the durability of response. Mm-hmm. I think also thinking forward, the data for those who have brain metastasis is also superior with the combination. Right. And so knowing that certainly for someone who already has brain mets, brain metastases, you would want to consider the combination. I think in terms of discussing for someone who has a BRAF mutation, whether they would want to do targeted therapy first versus immunotherapy, some of the retrospective studies that have been shown in the neoadjuvant setting, as well as the fully retrospective setting that came more out of ASCO, show that long-term survival, that end of the curve that we're looking for, does seem to favor immunotherapy. Okay. And so for someone who doesn't have symptoms and sitting in front of you, I think many people, there's a rationale to still consider immunotherapy in that setting. But of course, those were retrospective studies. So I think also all still waiting for the EA6134 study and that outcome to really know. So, at our institution, we have the study open and we'd want to offer that to the patient who's fit and has a BRAF mutation.
So in the absence of data, till we get this data, is it more rational to say, I'll go with the dual immune checkpoint blockade and hold the targeted agent for BRAF in my back pocket, or just so I kind of understand?
Sure. Yeah. I think for a long time, people have done that, saving the BRAF inhibitor someone is symptomatic. That said, the long-term survival data and outcome data for dabrafenib, trametinib from the COMBI studies show that those with low LDH and have low disease burden actually are those who do very well with them long-term. So I think it's hard to say that, you know, one size fits all. I don't think you can say yet that one is exclusively better than the other. In the end, you know, the rubber still needs to meet the road, and we need to wait for the prospective results.
We will wait for the prospective results. Thank you so much.